Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my channel where we discuss all things logistics. Quite often I am asked about contracts and paperwork, and I normally respond letting you all know that you can either go to Google and download templates on your own, or you can go to my website, www.allthelogistics.com, and download my paperwork and convert it and make it your own. Now, what I did not realize is that a lot of you do not know how to complete the conversion, so this video today is going to teach you how to convert your document from PDF to Word, how to convert it from Word to PDF, and also how to add and remove your watermark. Now, if you are not already subscribed, I suggest you hit that button now. And I also want to let you all know that our Cyber Monday sale actually ends today at midnight. That means you still have the opportunity to get $50 off any of my courses. And again, that sale ends tonight at midnight Central Standard Time. Now, going right into our video, let's assume you went to my website already and you downloaded my documents. When you download them, they're going to automatically download to your computer in PDF format because that's the way that I save them. So assuming that you've downloaded them, now I do suggest before I go any further that you probably have this video pinged on your phone so that you can kind of go along with me on your computer. But if you decide not to do that, either way, you would just go to ilovepdf.com, and you can see that right here in the browser, and you would go to PDF to Word, because again, my documents are in PDF format. You would then hit select PDF file, and you would select my agreement, because that's what we're going to be changing over today. Hit open, click convert to Word, and then you're going to download Word. Now, once you download the Word document, it'll generate here. Now, normally around this area, it'll say something like protected view, enable editing. And there'll be a button right here that you'll have to click to enable editing. That didn't happen to me, but it may happen to you. So if that happens, it'll say protected view. Just hit the enable editing button. So right now you see that I am in Word because we already converted the document over to Word. And now since we enabled editing, we can click on pages in the page in different areas, and we can delete stuff, add stuff, remove stuff. Right here, you're going to click on my logo and a box should generate around it. Once that happens, you will then click either delete or backspace, and boom, that will be removed from the document. You would then further go through the document, and where it says all things logistics, you need to change that to your business name. Where it says my name, put your name. Where it says my email, put your email, and so on and so forth. You'll even be able to see the percentage that I charge, and you can change that percentage over, and whatever it is that you need to edit, you'll do so at that time. Now, let's show you how to put your logo on there. So mine is gone, and you need to know where your logo is saved at on your computer to make this a smooth process. In my case, I know where I saved it. So I'll just click right here. Then I'm going to go to Insert, and I'll go to Pictures, this device. From there, I'm going to go to Downloads, and I know I saved my logo under ATL. Logo, so I'm going to insert it here. Now, I did insert it really big, but of course, this is really a simple fix because you'll resize it and make it fit the contract. And let's just say that's where we wanted it. But of course, like I said, you can move that around and fix it up as you see, as you wish. So we got the logo on there, but if you scroll down, you will also notice that I have a watermark on here as well. Now, the watermark is on all of the pages, so we're going to want to remove that. Now, there's two ways to do it, and since everyone uses different versions of Windows, I'm just going to go to the search box and type in watermark, and you can do the same. When you type in watermark, you may see the option. It may say watermark, printed watermark, remove watermark. Click remove watermark. And what that would normally do is remove the watermark, but sometimes it doesn't. And if it doesn't, don't panic. What you would then do is just hover over the text where my watermark is, where my logo is, and you'll see that little cursor pop up with the four arrows, and you simply click, right click, and then you, once that box generates, just delete it. And you're going to have to do that on all three pages. Now, if that remove watermark tab would have worked, it would have removed it from all three pages, but it didn't work. So we're going to manually go through and remove my watermark from each page. So now that all the watermarks are removed, as you can see, they're going off each page, you're going to add your own watermark, which will be your logo, and do the same thing. Just type in watermark in the search box, but this time go to where it says watermark, then go down to custom watermark, click picture watermark, select picture, select from a file so that it'll go to your browser. Downloads, I'm already in. And then click the logo and insert it. Click apply, and then you can close it out, and you'll be able to scroll down the page and see that the watermark is now back on the page. Now, this did move my contract around a little bit, and you can just work through and align things as you should. It's really just because of the placement of the logo. Now that that's done, let's say you changed everything to your information for your business, and you'll save it. And once you'll save it, you'll then go back to I Love PDF. And once you get back to I Love PDF, you're now going to go to tools and go to Word to PDF. Because remember, you just converted that document from PDF to Word, you edited it, and now you need to put it back in PDF format so that it's locked, because you're not going to want to send your documents to your owner operators in Word format. So you'll then select Word files. That Word file that you will select will be that agreement, which you'll rename to your business agreement. Convert it, download it, and then once you open it, you now have your full agreement with your logo and your business information on it, your watermark, and everything else. And you'll go through and you can do that to all the documents that you convert, and you'll have all your paperwork that you'll need to start your business. So I hope this helps, and I will see you guys next time.
So if you've enjoyed this video and you want to continue to educate yourself on all things logistics, please like, share, and subscribe. And also remember, with all things logistics, you are in business for yourself, but never by yourself. I'll see you next time.